This was a 14-story office tower until Monday night, when it was brought down by Israeli airstrikes. People working here were called by the Israelis and told to get out. The whole neighborhood had to run, including the Al-Ghassas family. Hazem Al-Ghassas's apartment is next to the tower. His son Karim was born into this conflict. Luckily, he was sleeping away from the window. Hazem says he has no idea why the building was targeted.
I don't know what, why? Can you tell me why? I don't know.
One reason may have been that the Palestinian faction, the PFLP, had its radio station in the building.
We were working, and at 3:30 a.m. we got a call from the Israelis saying we had to evacuate the building immediately. And while we were coming out the door, it was hit with a warning missile.
Another high-rise hit across town. This building was one of the biggest in Gaza until it was struck on Monday night. Over 70 families lived here, but the building also had shops as well as offices for the Ministry of Public Works and Hamas. Abu Adnan al-Masri owned the coffee shop on the ground floor. He was still in shock the next day.
We are financially ruined. The loss is more than $100,000. My coffee shop and my other four shops. I have less than nothing.
Most homeowners and businesses don't have the luxury of insurance in Gaza. So when conflicts break out, they can lose everything. Jane Ferguson, Al Jazeera, Gaza.